Hello, North Valley kids. It's me, Pastor Brian, and I'm so excited to be with you. I hope you guys had an awesome week. And today we're going to be looking at a new story about how to be strong and courageous and be bold and unafraid. So I hope you guys are excited about that. But before we do, let's go ahead and sing these songs together.
The church is one foundation, is Jesus Christ her Lord. She is his new creation by water and the word. From heaven he came and sought her to be his holy bride. With his own blood he bought her, and for her life he died. One foundation, on Christ we stand. One foundation, on Christ we stand. The church is one foundation, is Jesus Christ her Lord.
One foundation.
I hope you guys enjoyed singing those songs. And now we're going to look at a story about a very courageous person named Stephen. Now, Stephen was probably a pretty normal person, like you or me. And when the church started to grow, there were all of these things that were happening that weren't getting done right. And so the disciples said, hey, we need some help. So they picked Stephen and some other guys to help make sure everything was working right within the church. The Bible tells us that Stephen was very gifted. He listened to the Holy Spirit. He was able to do signs and wonders, and he was able to talk about Jesus very, very well. And in fact, some people didn't like it because they were trying to argue with Stephen, but they would always lose the argument. Well, this didn't go well because some of them decided to arrest him and lie about him, say that he was saying things that he never said. But Stephen, instead of backing down, decided to be courageous, and he took his opportunity to tell everyone there about who Jesus really was. And he told them about the Old Testament and about how God had a special plan to save people. But every time God had this plan, the people would oftentimes reject the plan that God had. And he was saying, listen, God had this awesome plan in sending Jesus, his son, but you guys are rejecting it. In fact, you guys even killed Jesus, and you're not following God. Well, when they heard this, they became so mad at Stephen that they took him outside the city, and they threw rocks at him, and they killed him. Now, that's kind of sad, but the cool part about the story is that Jesus didn't leave Stephen, and he helped him. Even in that difficult time, Jesus was there with Stephen and helping him through that. But let's go ahead and watch this video. It's going to help us understand the story a little better.
Hey everyone, Megan here, and I'm Jesse. Megan, I am so angry.
Uh-oh. Why, Jesse? What happened?
My little brother told my mom a lie. He said I knocked over her plant and spilled dirt all over the floor when he was the one who did it.
Uh-oh, that is not good. Did you get in trouble?
Almost, but when I told my mom what happened, she believed me. She made him clean it up.
Oh, well, good. That was a close call.
Yeah, but I'm still mad at my brother. He tried to get me in trouble.
You know what? That reminds me of today's Bible story. Some of the Jews didn't like a man named Stephen who loved and followed Jesus. They told lies about him to try to get him in trouble.
Oh no, did it work?
Well, kind of, but God was with Stephen. Listen to the story.
Stephen was a man who loved Jesus. He served the church. God was good to Stephen and gave him power to do great things. One day, some Jews told lies about Stephen. They did not like Stephen, and they wanted him to get in trouble. The high priest asked Stephen if the Jews were telling the truth. Stephen answered by teaching the Jewish leaders about Jesus. He started in the Old Testament with stories about Abraham and Isaac, Joseph and Moses. In those days, God was working out his plan to bring someone into the world who could save people from their sins. God chose to do great things through his people, the Israelites. He rescued them from slavery in Egypt. And even though the people did not obey God or love God like they should, God did not give up on them. God worked through Joshua and King David and King Solomon. Stephen taught the religious leaders new things. He said that Jesus is the Messiah, and the religious leaders were wrong to reject him and kill him on the cross. The religious leaders were so angry. They did not like what Stephen was saying. But Stephen looked up and said, I see the heavens open, and Jesus is standing at God's right side. Suddenly, the people yelled and rushed toward Stephen. They made Stephen leave the city, and then they threw rocks at him. Stephen said, Jesus, forgive them. Then he died. People hurt Stephen because he followed Jesus. Jesus told his disciples that people would hurt them for loving him. When people are mean to us because we love Jesus, we can be brave because people hurt Jesus too. Jesus died and came back to life, and one day we will live with him forever.
All right, well, I hope you guys enjoyed that story. And you know, it's not always easy, you know, watching some of these stories and seeing what happened to Stephen. But the good news is that even though things are hard, ultimately, we can love and trust Jesus. And Jesus went through all of those things too. And so we can trust that he'll be there in those hard times. All right, well, now let's go ahead and take a look at our big picture question. Our big picture question for today is, what is the church? The church is all Christians everywhere. And so just a reminder, guys, the church isn't just a building. It's all the people who love and follow Jesus. We're the church. It's all Christians everywhere. And now let's look at our memory verse. Our memory verse for today is Romans 12:5. We who are many are one body in Christ. And that's the same thing as our big picture question, right? Even though we're all different people, we're all part of the body of Christ. That means we're the church. We're supposed to go and tell others about Jesus and do the things that he would have us do. All right, well, let's go ahead and sing this song to help us remember the verse. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed singing that song. And now let's just say a quick word of prayer before you guys go. Dear Jesus, be with my friends. Lord, help them to be courageous and to tell others about Jesus. We love you and we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, well, you guys, I hope you enjoyed your lesson for today. Can't wait to see you again soon. Bye-bye.